Coach Jeff Collins. Coach, if you could open us up with a statement before we take questions.
First of all, hats off to Notre Dame. That's a really good football team. But I thought we got out-coached, we got out-executed, and we got out-physical throughout the game. Response to adversity was not like we've shown in previous weeks. And you know, we got to find a way. We've got the number one team in the country coming into town next Saturday. So got to watch this, learn from this, and get ready for next week. But that one hurt. Obviously, they're hurting in there, and has not been the type of football that we've played and battled the last couple of weeks. So just got to get better. It starts with me.
Kelly?
It seemed like things fell out of control after the pick six early in the game. You get the stop, hold them to a field goal.
Yep.
And then the pick six, and then it just seemed like the wheels came off.
Yep, I don't disagree with that, Kelly. I was that opening drive. They get the kickoff return. We lost leverage by two guys on the perimeter, which can't happen against a good returner. They cross the 50. They get down into the red zone, and the guys had the proper mindset, the right mentality. They get a stop. They force a field goal. Then we come out and throw a pick six. And then weren't able to respond really for the rest of the first half. And you know, so that was disappointing to see. And we're gonna find a way to get it right.
John.
Yeah, you're kind of looking at this is pretty historical loss, probably the tie for the worst margin victory. What do you say to the fans and donors to give them confidence that you're still the guy for the job at this point?
Yeah, just the locker room's the first and foremost thing that I'm concerned about, and there's some hurting guys in there, and so I'll just, you know, one of the seniors gave a pretty impassioned speech about how much this means to him and means to us, and so that's all I'm concerned about right now, and we'll just keep it there.
Ken?
One of the big plays in the first quarter, Meyer got free, and obviously this has happened before. If it looked like, I don't know, can you describe what happened and just how it, like, what does it say that it seems like the sort of progress you want to make back there is going to be happening?
Yeah, that was a disappointing one. Especially to happen early in that kind of scenario, but just should have bumped the coverage. And we had it wired and had three guys covered too. And then the one didn't get bumped to him like it should. And so obviously that is frustrating. So.
Is that you talked before about communication and trust. Was that the same sort of thing, or it was?
Yeah, just a little bit of the in the play communication. It wasn't an easy route versus that coverage, but we still got to get it pushed one layer over to get it covered, and we did not do that.
Kelly?
It seemed like you guys just couldn't block them on offense, and Jordan was running for his life at times and made a lot of mistakes just off of that, but were you satisfied with just the execution? What were you seeing with in terms of the offense and the blocking and just the calls too on that side of the ball?
Yeah, getting in the hole so early, and then trying to, you know, throw our way into it, back into it, and then not being able to protect. And they were running some good pressures, but still got to be able to hold up. And you know, the guys that were rolling in, you know, kept fighting, kept competing. But that, I mean, hats off to Notre Dame and their front getting pressure on us.
Okay.
When you say out-coached, was there a particular element of that that you feel like you guys weren't to their name standard?
Yeah, I mean, first of all, Ken, that's one of the top teams in college football. They do a really nice job. They've got a long history of developing and being in their system and all of those kind of things. So they've got a really good program, so hats off to them, first and foremost. But just the response to adversity, that was disappointing today. We have not shown that since game five of the season, and it showed up today. And when you have that show up today against one of the top teams in college football, they can put a score like that on you, and it happened today.
You mentioned a lot of your players are hurting. Is that a discourage, an anger? Is that frustration? Can you kind of give a little bit further as to what the tone of the team in the locker room is?
That's actually a good question. There's layers as you're building a program, and the responses. As you're building it and getting closer, and the response to the losses at times, it grows, but it's the right amount of anger was there last week. The right amount of anger is there right now, and so just gotta come back and regroup and put another week of prep to get ready for a great Georgia team.
Come.
I guess kind of in a bigger picture thing, how do you fix it? Like, how do you, is it coaching, player development? Kind of where do you see the cracks that kind of lead to this game or the Pitt game right now?
Yeah, and I think it's everything, and I told them in there, I told the guys in there, obviously after every single week, every single thing in the program is evaluated, from how we do our planning and weekend scheduling, and everything is evaluated and looked at, and this week is no different. And the last week of the season, everything has to be evaluated, big picture, so we can take the next big step in the program. Battling close games, all of those things are stepping stones. But then you have a game like this, and it's a setback, and it, you've got to learn from it, got to take away where we are, and how to get to where we're going to be, and everything in the offseason heading into next year, big picture-wise. But we've got a great Georgia team coming into town on Saturday, and, we've got to learn from this one and get ready to play on Saturday.
Anything else?
I guess, does it concern you seeing how the team performed against a very good team today, that you face basically an elite team next week that's even better than them? And I imagine that's got to be a little upsetting, that you're not playing your best football when you get ready to go into that rivalry game.
I'm with you, Kelly. I mean, everything's looked at every single week. And just the guys getting ready to play, put a good plan together for them to execute at a high level next Saturday against a good team.
Anything else? All right. Thank you.